Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mitesh Gala. Welcome to Rough Book, a learning companion.
So this topic is because whenever in the words you see the sums related to probability, they are the most simplest ones, and one sum 100% comes in the board. So you have full chance of getting those 3 marks straight away into your pocket, and sometimes it also appears in section A. So I want everyone to focus, very simple topic. All those children who struggle to score very well, this is the topic where you can really bank upon. So let us first try and understand what do you mean by the word probability. So probability is nothing else but a chance. Chance as in whether the chances of an event occurring is greater, lesser, or in numbers we'll try and find it out whether it is possible or no. So in one of the movies it was shown how a gambler happens to use this probability technique in order to understand what is his chance of winning in that gamble, and probably he wins over the game. So here we are not talking about gambling, obviously. We are talking about probability means the events that can be possible or not possible to what extent. Let's take a simple example. Probability can happen with a coin. What is the chance of getting a head or a tail? It can happen with a dice. From 1 to 6 numbers, what is the probability of getting even numbers or odd numbers or a particular number that you are looking out for? Or it can also happen between a race between two people. What is the chance of one person winning and the second person winning? It can also happen with some numbers. It can happen with some colors. So a lot of avenues are there where we can apply this probability technique. So we'll just take few questions and that will help us to understand. Before we start hitting the questions, one basic thing you need to understand. Let's take, if I take a coin. So first you need to have the parts of the probability in your mind very clear. So the first part is called as sample space. Sample space means all the possible events. So if a coin is tossed, what are the possible events? The events are either you can get a head or you can get a tail. These are the two possible events. Out of this, let's say if you are looking out for head or if you are banking on head. So here, what is the cardinal number for this? 2. So there are two possibilities. So number of S is 2. S is sample space. Sample means all possible events. Let's move forward. Now you are banking on head. So you are looking at an event. Let's say event A, which should turn up as a head. Alright. So what is the cardinal number for this? 1. So what is your probability of winning, probability of A or probability of the event? It is the number of possible outcomes upon number of total outcomes. So possible outcome is 1 because only one head can turn up, and total outcomes are 2. So your probability of winning on head is half, or you can say 50%. We are always going to write probability in terms of fractions. We will never write it in decimals. Even decimals are accepted, but we will avoid. We will not write it in percentage, and neither will we write it in mixed fraction. It is not possible in mixed fraction because every time you see the number of total events are down. So this is going to be a number bigger than this always. Keep that thumb rule in your head that this is going to be a number bigger than this. Are you getting it? This will be bigger than this. So your probability will always be equal to or less than 1. Either equal to 1 or less than 1. It can't be greater than 1 because this number is bigger. Are you getting it? You will never get more than 1 point something or 2, 3, 4, anything like that. You will always get it as lesser than or equal to 1. Will you remember this part? Yeah. So let's take few questions. First, remember sample space, number of samples, event space, number of events, and then probability is number of possible events upon number of total events. So you get your final answer. This is exactly how you are supposed to present your question. I want everyone to try sum number 1 on their own. Very simple, based on the same technique of a coin. So come on, go ahead, try your best and let's see how many of you can manage it. Let's say a coin is tossed once. So what is your sample space? Head or tail? You are allowed to write H and T, no problem. So number of S is 2. The first event they say, getting a tail. So what is the possibility of getting a tail? Only one tail is there. So number of A becomes what? 1. So probability of A is number of A upon number of S. That becomes 1 by 2. Is everyone clear with this? Did you manage to get this? Come on, pause the video, try and get the second possibility now. Not getting a tail. So not getting a tail means what do you want? You want head. So number of b becomes what? 1 again. So probability of b becomes again number of b upon number of s, that is 1 by 2. Because number of b is 1 and number of possible outcomes are 2. So it becomes half again. Isn't it very, very simple? Let's take one more. I want everyone to try some number 2. Remember the parts. If you stick to this, it's going to be very simple. First, sample, number of sample, event, number of event, probability. Event, number of event, probability. Probability, the bottom is total and up is the possible outcomes that you are going to get. Are you clear with this now, everybody? Any doubts still here? Yeah, you will find this topic very, very simple. So don't worry at all. Sum number 2, try it. A bag contains 3 white, 5 black, 2 red balls. So what is your sample space? It has 3 white balls. So 3 white, 5 black and 2 red. So what is the total number of sample? 5 plus 3, 8 plus 2, 10. So your total sample is 10. Now they say a ball is drawn from the bag without looking into it. Find the probability that the ball drawn is a black ball. So what are the possible outcomes? So number of A. So first event. Black ball, so how many black? 5 black. Correct? So what is your number of A? 5. So what will be the probability of A? 5 by 10. 1 by 2. Because 5 upon the total possible outcomes. Are you getting it? Simple. Am I going fast? Oh, I'm going slow. Achha. Chalo, let's go with the next one. Event B. Come on, try reading it. Understand it and try it out. Let's see how many of you can tackle it. So B says a red ball. So 2 red balls. So number of B is 2. This is event space. This is number of events. Okay. So probability of B, 2 by 10, 1 by 5. How many got this 1 by 5? Great job. Let's look at the third part now. Third one says a white ball. So C is white. White is what? 3 white. So number of C becomes 3. So probability of C becomes 3 by 10. One important thing. If this can be reduced, the answer has to be in the reduced form. If you leave the answer here, you will lose 1 mark straight away. The board clearly mentions that if the answer can be reduced, you are expected to write it in the reduced form only. Event number 4. Not a red ball. See, now they are using negation. Not a red one. So that means it can be 3 white or 5 black. Either of them. So the total becomes how many? So number of D becomes 5 plus 3, 8. So probability of D becomes 8 by 10. If I leave it here, 1 mark lost. It has to be 4 by 5. Last, fifth one. Not a black. So event E, not a black. So it can be 3 white or 2 red. Correct? So total number of E becomes 3 plus 2, 5. So probability of E becomes 5 by 10, 1 by 2. Who got all correct? Wow. Good job. Let's go with the next one. Sum number 4. 4 is based on a die. So let's see how many can tackle with the die. How many numbers on the die? Have you played anything with the dice? Yeah, I know. Right now in the lockdown, most of you are doing that only. You do, isn't it? Okay. So sample space 1 to 6. Because on a die, you have numbers till 6. So possible outcomes, how many? 6. Let's look at the first event. Will be an even number. So what are the even possibilities on this? 2, 4 and 6. So number of A becomes 3. So probability of A, 3 by 6 becomes half. That should be my first event. Let's look at the second event. Will not be an even number. So if not an even number, what it can be? So even numbers are not there. So obviously odd numbers, 1, 3 and 5. So number of B becomes 3. So probability of B, 3 by 6, again 1 by 2. Let's look at the third one. Come on, pause the video now at least and try it on your own. So the third one says, will be an odd number. So it has to be the same thing. So don't write same as B. You actually write it and show it to them again. So 1, 3, 5. So number of C is 3. So probability of C becomes 3 by 6. Reduce it. Don't forget to reduce. Otherwise you will 100% lose one mark. So did you notice all the three answers are half only? Yeah. Did you manage to get all three correct? Great. So you have become masters with this? Obviously no, because these are all stupid questions. The tougher ones are yet to come. Sum number 5, put a star beside it and put a circle also. We'll get back to sum number 5 a little later. I want everyone to try sum number 7 first. 5 we will do right in the end. It is related to cards. Okay. So 7th one. In a TT match, Geeta and Ritu. So there is a TT match between Geeta and Ritu. The probability of winning of Ritu. So probability of Ritu is 0.73. Then find the probability of winning of Geeta. Now the total probability of both will always be 1. Let's take one previous example to understand this. Here they said 5 black and here they said 3 white and 2 red. So black, white, red makes the entire set. If you look at this, this is half. And if you look at this, this also is half. If you add both of them, it will become 1. That means the whole package. Are you getting it? So the possible outcomes total will always be equal to 1. Likewise, Ritu and Geeta. So if Ritu and Geeta, two people are there, that total package will become 1. So probability of Ritu is given. So what will be probability of Geeta? 1 minus probability of Ritu. Because their total is 1. Are you getting it? So it will be 1 minus 0.73. So it should be 0.27. This is the probability of Geeta winning. So who's got a greater chance of winning? Obviously Ritu, not Geeta. Are you getting it? The second part, not winning of Ritu. This is first part. Second part, not winning of Ritu. That means who's winning? Geeta. So you can say not winning of Ritu is equal to Geeta winning. And Geeta winning, we have already found the answer. That is 0.27. The same answer repeats. Simple? Yeah, don't expect such simple questions in the exam. Huh? They are just making you understand the concept of 1. Okay. Let's take the next one. Sum number 8. Similar concept, right? In a race between Mahesh and John, the probability of John will lose the race is 0.54. So John losing is equal to Mahesh winning, correct? So if Mahesh is winning, then what is the chance? 0.54. So probability of Mahesh is 0.54. The first question is, what is the probability of winning of Mahesh? So we already gave it to them. Second, what is the probability of John winning? So probability of John winning is 1 minus probability of Mahesh from the previous concept that we just got. So when you subtract, you should get it as 0.46. See, John losing, I can write over here P is equal to probability of Mahesh winning. So that is 0.54. Are you getting the logic? Yeah, easy. Let's take the next one. I want everyone to try sum number 11. 11 is a good concept. In fact, 10 also. So let's take 10 and 11 both. So start with 10 first. In a single throw of die. So what are the possibilities? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So number of S becomes 6. Now the first event they say, getting a 5. So A becomes how much? 5. So number of A is equal to 1. And probability of A becomes 1 by 6. Was this simple? Getting a 5 means not 5 numbers. Getting only this 5. So this is just one number. So 1 by 6. Try the second one. Second one they say 8. So is there 8 in this slot? Obviously 8 is not there. So what will you write over here? Don't write 0. Leave it empty. And number of B becomes 0. This is empty because 8 is not available. So therefore probability of B becomes 0 by 6. If you leave it here, you still lose one mark. You are expected to write it as 0 with no denominators. Only 0 please. Is that clear? Let's take the third part. The third one says a number less than 8. So less than 8, all the numbers are possible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as well as 6. So probability of C is 6 by 6, that is 1. These two both are epic. Number 1 they said over here in this, greater than this which is not available, that is 8. So 0. And second one they said less than 8, that means all of them. So if all of them I am taking up, it has to be 6 by 6. Automatically it becomes 1. Are you with me? And then the last one, the fourth probability, event D. Event D, they say a prime number. Now here what will be the prime numbers? You tell me, come on. Yes, tell me. Did you take 1, 2, 3, 5? Wrong. Because 1 is not a prime number. That's a wrong notion. Only 3 prime numbers, that is 2, 3 and 5. So number of D should be 3. And then probability of the 3 by 6, 1 by 2. Are you getting this? Please don't mess it up. Yeah, 1 is not a prime number. Remember that throughout the 10th standard. I have seen so many children taking 1 as a prime number and messing the entire sum. Okay, let's go with the next one. I want everyone to try some number 11. A die is thrown once. So again, sample 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So number of S becomes 6. Further, probability getting an even number. Chalo, very simple. So A will become 2, 4 and 6. So number of A is 3. So probability of A is 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. Easy? Let's take the second event. A number between 3 and 8. Pause the video, write it first and then come back. A number between 3 and 8. So did you write 4, 5 and 6? Hamni wrote 3, 7 and 8 also. Wrong. Number 1, 7 and 8 can't be here because they are not a part of sample. And 3 cannot be because they said between 3 and 8. So you don't have to include 3. So therefore your number of B becomes 3. So probability of B becomes 3 by 6. That is 1 by 2. You don't need to write number of outcomes upon number of total outcomes and all that. Just write this much. This is more than enough in the boards. The third part, an even number or a multiple of 3. Come on, pause, think, read it twice and then try it. It's a good one. An even number or a multiple of 3. So even numbers are 2, 4, 6. And multiples of 3 are 3 and 6. So 6 is already there, I don't need to write, 3 I just wrote. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So number of C is 4. Probability of C becomes 4 by 6, 2 by 3. This is good one. Yeah, people get confused when the word or is there. Or means you have to include both, but only once. So 6 was repeated, we used it only once and not twice. The next one I want you to try is some number 14. 14 is a classic question in the boards. This year a similar question came and many children messed it up. That's why I thought I will pick up 14. 14 says a simple letter is selected at random from the word probability. Find the probability that it is a vowel. So your sample space, all the alphabets that are used, P, R, O. Now R is repeated. Should I write it second time? Think. No, R is not there, B is there, from A, and now B is repeated. So should I write it second time? Yes, you are expected to write it. I, probability, L, I, T and Y. So even if it repeats twice, you are expected to write it two times. Okay, now vowel. So first number of S, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, now what is your event? So all the vowels, O, A, I, see, O, A, I. Second time I repeat it, should I write it? Yes, you are expected because there is a greater chance since it is repeated twice. Alright, so number of A will be 4 and therefore probability of A 4 by 11. How many got this correct? How many in the first place didn't copy and do it on their own? Wow, if you've done it on your own, I am really impressed. And how many did it on their own and they got it correct? That's more important. They got it correct. How many got this correct? 14th one. Wow, I'm really impressed. Last 15th one. Everyone pause the video this time, try it on your own, it's slightly different. It says Ramesh chooses a date at random in January for a party. So entire month of January becomes your sample set. So you don't need to write 1 to 31, you can just write dates 1 to 31 of January. So therefore your event, number of samples become 31. Now that you know your number of samples, let's look at the first event. So first event is, they say, a Wednesday. So Wednesday, so what are the Wednesdays that are possible is what we need to look at. So let's look at the table. All days of Wednesday we have to take 1, 8, 15, 22 and 29. So 5 Wednesdays are there. So how will you write? So you write Wednesday 1, 8, 15, 22 and 29. So therefore number of A is how much? 5. So probability of A 5 by 31. So getting a Wednesday is 5 times out of 31. Why 31? Because total outcomes are 31 and 5 is possible because 5 Wednesdays are there. Let's look at the second event. Getting a Friday. So look at the Fridays with whatever dates. So Friday with dates 3, 10, 17, 24 and 31. So again 5. So number of B should be 5. So probability of B becomes again 5 by 31. And last part, a Tuesday or a Saturday. So two possibilities they have given us. Okay. A Tuesday or a Saturday. So first I will write Tuesdays. What are the available Tuesdays? 7, 14, 7, 14, 21, 28 and second is Saturday with what dates? 4, 11, 18, 4, 11, 18 and 25. So how many days in all? Because they use the word or, you're going to include both. So therefore number of C becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So therefore your probability of C becomes 8 by 31. Because 8 days are possible out of 31 days. Did you manage to get this? Great. This last one was slightly different. Rest all simple. Let me tell you one thing openly. Exercise A is a very simple exercise. Nothing you can expect from this in the exam. This is just a stepping stone. The next exercise is a lovely exercise what we need to pick up. I have left one sum, that is sum number 5. Which I am going to do in the next video when I will be doing similar sums. At the moment your homework will be exercise 25A. I want you to try sum number 2, 3. If I have done 2, please do it again. 2, 3, 10. Even if I am repeating the numbers, please do it again for better practice. And you can try 13. That's it. This is what I want you to try for your homework. So until the next video when I do the second exercise of probability, which is more important, please stay safe, stay healthy. Bye, take care, pray for everyone.
Hope you had a lovely mathematics experience with the Rough Book, our learning companion.